Hey, they're here, so welcome to the Vector channel. So this is gonna be kind of a brief video because it's about one little trick that actually can change completely your experience with the Oculus Quest 2. Because as you might know, we all have different faces, whoever thought that, right? And one crucial thing we talked about the Oculus Quest 2 during my review is that we have unlimited IPD adjustment with just three sections, 58mm, 63mm and 68mm. And personally for me, as I said in my review, it was a little uncomfortable to wear for my eyes, and also I had some glaring issue and chromatic aberration. So if your experience is the same, this is the right video for you because we're gonna see how to fix it together. Let's get into it. So just to explain very briefly why this is so important, we have to understand IPD, the interpupillary distance, that is the distance between the pupils of your eyes, of course. To measure it's super easy, there are many apps on the App Store or a Play Store, or you can just go in the front of the mirror, take a scale, like this one with the millimeters, this is from IKEA, by the way, you put it in front and you measure the distance from one to the other. At the point, you know the number, for me is 66.4, and of course, the Oculus Quest 2 has a 63 or 68, so I'm right there in the middle. Bummer. And you want to be right in the center of the lenses to be able to see the screen in the right way possible with the right distortion and stuff like that. So if you sit on the right IPD, lucky you. If you don't, well, luckily there's something you can do. It doesn't do miracles, but it makes the experience much, much better. And for me, it was a completely thing changer. So the thing that you can do, by the way, is to move the lenses between the 2 and 3 settings or the 1, 2 and 3 settings. For that, you have to be very careful and move them very slowly, as you can see, and try to understand a little what is the distance that you will have. For me, for example, 66.4, I'm a little above the middle of the 2 and 3, so I'm gonna go in the middle and then move it just a little, and in that way I'm gonna get to the best position possible for my eyes. And a good thing that is pretty sturdy is gonna stay there without any problem, without snapping back on the 2 or number 3, but it's very easy anyway to adjust every time. Now, this helps a lot for eye comfort, but it's not gonna change the software that's always gonna stay in the 63 settings or 68 settings or in the 58 settings. So what I suggest to do is to start from 63, 68 or 58, depends of course on your IPD, see which one is more comfortable of the three, and then after that, put it on there, and in case, go down from 68 or go up from 63 or go up from 58 or go down from 63, and you're gonna have the best eye comfort possible out there. I'm not a fan of the Oculus solution, by the way. I think that the slider was completely fine, but they wanted to make it easier. And in my case, I got some glare, I got some chromatic aberration when you see on the edges of the screen, letters with like the blue and the red shift attached to it. That is not a nice thing to see. And well, with this thing, we can already fix it a little. Now, maybe in the future, they're gonna arrive, if enough people ask, with an update to actually change the IPD settings also in the software, not just with those three settings, but there's something that we need to start to ask to Oculus, and I think it is possible because it's something that was possible already with the original Quest. Maybe just an experimental version or stuff like it will really give a boost. Now, if you don't do it, doesn't mean that it's not usable anymore. It's still usable anyway. You get used to it after just a little. I just don't suggest to use the setting one if you have a very high IPD. So always try to check it before, know where you're at, and then just remember the number because it's gonna be attached for you forever in your VR life, at least since we have an option to do it automatically. But yeah, that was all, guys. This was my little trick. It really helped me to enjoy even more the Oculus Quest 2, and I hope it's gonna help you as well. So don't panic if you see some glaring, don't panic if you see some chromatic aberration right now, and don't panic if you don't see it in the right number and you say, oh, I can't use it. Well, you can. You have just little trick to do, but hey, we gotta do what we gotta do, right? Anyway, guys, if you liked the video, like. If it was helpful, like. If you didn't like the video, like. Subscribe to the channel for more about VR tech. And if you really love the channel, the join button down there that really helps over here. And a little down further, we also have the Patreon that they have prior access to videos, of course, and different giveaways. So check it out for sure. And at the same time, we have the t-shirt, sticker, and mask 2020 item number 1. Enjoy your weekend and enjoy your Oculus Quest 2. I see you guys soon. Like, dislike, subscribe.